What's up, guys? It's Jordy here for Cinecom.net, and welcome to Creative Tuesday. And I hope that you've had a great weekend. Mine was better than last weekend when I broke my wrist and I actually removed the cast from it because I didn't like it. So I just got myself a wrist protector. That's the news. And I should have worn this last week when I was skateboarding, because that is how I broke my wrist. And I even got it on tape. If you haven't seen that video yet, you can find it in the description below. You know, at first it was pretty cool, doing this laser flip in slow motion, but then it got embarrassing. Anyways, guys, I wanna talk about something different than my wrist, which is an effect that I use like very often inside Adobe Premiere Pro. And it's not like a very visual effect or something cool. I'm talking about the crop effect, a super simple effect, but I believe that you can create so many great clean and professional animations with it, and that is what I want to show you guys in this video. Now, before we start, a quick shout out to our sponsor, Rocketstock. Now, they've came out with another amazing video pack called Arctic, which is a collection of 79 snow, ice, and frost visual effects that are recorded on red cameras. So if you don't like the summer, just turn your videos into winter. To check it out, click the first link in the description below. So the crop effect simply cuts off a piece from any of the sides of your clip, title, or any other object. You can set a top and bottom crop to create that fake cinema scope. Now, if you have an entire edit, it's better to first create an adjustment layer on top and apply the crop effect on there. This also has the benefit that you can reframe each individual clips by moving their position. Now, what I love about creating crop marks with the crop effect is that you can animate it. If you cut to a B-roll sequence, you could have your crop marks close in, for instance. You can also play around with different aspect ratios and just really use those crop marks as a creative tool. For the next step, and I actually have 5 in total, I'm going to create some text and put the crop effect on there. Now, what I like to do quite often is reveal this text, and this is done by setting the bottom crop to where you want the text to appear. Then just animate the text position to let it reveal itself from behind the crop. And you can also animate the layer or motion position at the same time to get a more dynamic animation. You can really make some great text animations that look clean and professional with only the crop effect and basic properties. Next up is the split screen, which is super simple. You have 2 stacked clips on each other and the one on top gets a crop. But now it gets interesting when you animate the crop effect coming in. So let's just start animating the crop effect so that it reveals the upper layer until 50%. This will overlap the clip below. So I'm going to animate the bottom clip's position and push it a little bit to the side. It's also best that you smooth out any keyframe to let it start and stop gently. We actually have a dedicated video about these techniques, which you can find somewhere in the description below. So that should give you something like this. Again, a clean way to introduce a split screen. And there are multiple ways to experiment on how to show a split screen. Moving on, the next trick is a transition, and we're going to do something different as we've done before with the text and the split screen. You can already place 2 clips in your timeline, but make sure that they overlap where you're going to add your transition. I'm gonna add the crop effect to both of the clips. For the one below, I will enable zoom and animate the bottom crop, and this will stretch out the video. For the clip on top, I'm going to animate the bottom as well from 100 to 0. And this gives you a very nice parallax transition. Another cool transition idea is where you animate both the left and the right from the bottom clip to around 30%, having the zoom enabled. And this will stretch out the clip horizontally. The top clip will get 2 crop effects. Animate on where the left crop goes from 50 to 0 and do the same with the second crop effect, but then for the right property. This will open up the clip from the middle and the bottom clip will react on that with the stretch. Again, a cool idea, and I hope that it also opens up some more ideas for you when creating some nice transitions. And finally is the effect wipe. So your bottom clip has several effects on it. Duplicate that clip to the layer above for the amount of how many effects you have on it. I have 3 effects, so I'll duplicate it 3 times. The layer on top should have all the effects. From the one below, you want to remove 1 effect. From the clip below that, you remove 2 effects, and so on. Your bottom clip should have no effects applied. Then apply the crop effect to the second layer. Animate any property from 100 to 0, which will reveal itself. Then copy the entire crop effect, go a little further in time, trim the next clip to your playhead, and paste the crop effect. Go again a little bit further, trim, and paste. And that will give you a nice way to represent a breakdown of your effects. Now, the reason that I'm preferring this over animating masks and each effect is that you again have more control over the keyframes. As you can see, they come in fast, slow down, and go out fast again. And this is something that you cannot do with the mask path animation. So there you have it, 5 ways to use the crop effect inside Adobe Premiere Pro. Thank you all so much for watching, thank you Rocketstock for the support, and like always, stay creative.
So as you guys know, Lorenzo has been doing an internship at Cinecom, but now he's gone, so we had to find someone new to replace him. And look who we got, he's standing here, behind the C-stand, it is Lorenzo! He's back. Now go clean the studio, Lorenzo, okay?